Hello everyone, welcome to Pro Trader Talks. Very often, we tend to compare trading with gambling. Well, one major reason could be perhaps that both of these fields have an unlimited potential for losses. But once I got really curious and I kind of found out what is the difference between, you know, for instance, between poker and trading, and I found out quite some interesting stuff. Many short-term traders, they enjoy poker and they're really quite good at it. So let's take a look at some of the similarities between the poker, I mean Texas Hold'em poker and trading, or explore karte hain ki dono mein common kya cheeze hain. सबसे पहले एंड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग्स दैट्स कॉमन बिटवीन बोथ ऑफ देम इज दैट वन नीड्स टू हैव अ कूल एंड अ काम टेम्परामेंट एट बोथ ऑफ देम और ये टेम्परामेंट इसलिए चाहिए बिकॉज बोथ आर द गेम्स ऑफ वॉलेटिलिटी इमोशंस अगर आपके कंट्रोल में नहीं है देन यू मे हैव अ वेरी गुड प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ डैमेजिंग योर गेम जस्ट बाय लेटिंग द इमोशंस टेक यू ओवर और सबसे प्रोमिनेंट इमोशंस जो दोनों में होते हैं वो होते हैं ग्रीड होप एंड फियर सो हैविंग अ कूल एंड अ काम टेम्परामेंट गोज अ रियल लॉन्ग वे इफ यू वांट अ रियल गुड विनिंग हैंड इन बोथ सेकंड वन इज दैट बोथ आर हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी परफॉर्मेंस एक्टिविटीज द पोकर प्लेयर एज वेल एज द ट्रेडर हैज अ लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू प्ले मल्टीपल टाइम्स ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स ऑफ वन डे द हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी नेचर ऑफ पोकर हैंड्स एज वेल एज द नंबर ऑफ ट्रेड्स means that performance sees a lot of patterns in a short period of time aur isliye unka learning curve bahut jaldi accelerate hota hai and this also helps most poker players and short term traders to be self taught people aur shayad isliye trading ke profession mein learning ki bahut hi resistance hoti hai because unhe lagta hai ki game dekh dekh kar aur market mein trading kar kar ke main to seekh hi lunga over a period of time so These guys, they tend to learn through repeated observations and experiences. Seeing many hands in many different gaming situations and learning from our successes and failures and mistakes is a great teacher in both of these games. The third one is that ye dono mein, there is a combination of a statistical edge plus discretionary judgment. And this makes it so interesting. For example, suppose एक दिन मार्केट सडनली क्रैश हो गया इट्स सोल्ड ऑफ और देर इज बीन अ वेरी गुड देर बीन रिकॉर्ड वॉल्यूम ऑफ ऑप्शंस व्हाइल सेलिंग फॉर इंस्टेंस तो देर इज ऑलवेज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग एज टू द अपसाइड दैट द ट्रेडर हैज सिमिलरली अगर आप पोकर खेल रहे हो और आपके हाथ में दो एस आ गए रादर देन एज कंपेयर टू आर टू और नाइन अनसूटेड जस्ट कंपेयर बोथ ऑफ दिस सिनेरियोज एंड थिंक अबाउट इट दोनों कॉन्टेक्स्ट में नीदर द शॉर्ट टर्म ट्रेडर नॉर द पोकर प्लेयर will just lavishly follow the odds. You know why? Because it is also important to see what's happening into the moment. That is where the discretionary judgment enters. For instance, steep sell-off ke baad, aisa zaruri nahi hai ki wo short-term trader bullish market ki pattern pe bet karega hi. Wo trader apni discretionary judgment pe act karega. In the same way, ऐसा ज़रूरी नहीं है कि दो एस आने पे पोकर प्लेयर हार्ड बेट करेगा हैव यू नॉट सीन पोकर प्लेयर्स बेट ऑन यू नो हाई ऑन स्लो कार्ड्स बोथ द पोकर प्लेयर्स एज वेल एज शॉर्ट टर्म ट्रेडर्स दे नीड टू हैव एन एज बट एट द सेम टाइम दे मस्ट ऑल्सो बी एबल एंड रेडी टू यूज देयर रियल टाइम जजमेंट एज टू व्हेन टू प्रोसीड विद दीज ऑड्स एंड दैट इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट नंबर फोर बोथ ऑफ दीज फील्ड्स दे रिक्वायर डिसिप्लिन मनी मैनेजमेंट फॉर एग्जाम्पल पोकर में अगर आप ऑल इन आ गए आपको बढ़िया स्कोर मिलना इज वेरी हाईली प्रोबेबल एंड दिस गाइड इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर इंस्टेंस इन पोकर वंस यू गो ऑल इन ऑफकोर्स आई विल ब्रिंग योर क्विक स्कोर बट ऑल्सो अ क्विक एग्जिट फ्रॉम द टेबल इन द सेम वे बेटिंग टू लार्ज कंपेयर टू योर रिस्क मैनेजमेंट कैन टोटली रूइन योर ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट सो बोथ दीज पोकर प्लेयर्स एज वेल एज ट्रेडर दे नो हाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट इट इज to go for an advantage and press it when the time comes when it's actually there a huge percentage of profits would come from relatively smaller number of trades and the same it is with poker as well staying into the game is the key in both the fields. And this requires you to follow the right money management techniques. Number five, and a very important one, is if you want to win at both, you need to have a willingness to not play. And this is really ironical, but think about it, it's really important. Poker khelte waqt aapko haath mein do cards diye jaate hain, and then slowly the new cards are revealed, the flop, turn and river, right? In the same way, market action goes on, you know, starts unveiling itself step by step, and at any point of time you can decide whether you want to bet or not, and you can decide how much you want to bet. Good poker players, they muck many hands, and they don't bet when the odds are not in their favor. Similarly, good traders will similarly stand aside if they do not see a market that provides sufficient volume and volatility. So the key, my friends, is knowing when to play and how aggressively to play. And this is a major element of success in both the profession. And last but not the least, winning at these both require, you know, whom are you playing against? In poker, you would bet differently in a small table than a larger one. You would bet differently in a local casino while playing with amateurs than during late rounds at a professional tournament. Over a period of time, poker players seekh hi jata hai patterns unke adversaries ki, aur yehi patterns aur yehi knowledge wo use karte hai to make better decisions. And in the same way, short-term traders, they over a period of time, they become sensitive to the impact of the larger market participants. If they see, I mean, wo dekhte hai ki whether the volume is entering the market and whether it's happening on the buying side or the selling side, and they adjust their strategies accordingly. So in a sense, both of these guys should have a shrewd psychology so that they get into the head of their competitors, and that's how it works. So all in all, these are the similarities, broad similarities between the two. Aur ek thode se common questions hai jo dono players ko at the beginning of the game apne aap ko pooch sakte hai. Is this the hand that I really want to play? How is the game progressing? I mean, how is my edge changing as the game is progressing? How much do I want to bet on this hand, and who is participating on the table with me? Which way are they leaning towards? Ek baar aap ye similarity samajh gaye, you would find it really easy to crack through, be it poker or be it trading. So guys, how about revising all six of them together? The first one is, you need to have a cool and a calm temperament in both the fields. Second is, you need to understand ki dono hi high frequency activities hai. Third one is, how about bringing in, they combine a combination of statistical edge with discretionary judgment. Next is, both of these require disciplined money management. Fifth is, winning at both require us a willingness of not to play. And the last is, you should know whom you are up against. Henceforth, whether you play poker or you are a short-term trader, ensure that you understand what goes behind each. And for those of you who have never explored the world of trading, how about learning some basics? How about learning stock trading in a simplified way so that you can level up your way to being a professional trader? And exactly isi points pe baat ki hum, maine aur Vishal ne hamari first book mein, which is called Hashtag Cash Tags, where we talk about four most important pillars of trading. If you haven't got a copy for yourself, please do get one today. Guys, I wish you joy and abundance in all you do.